Jesus, nós te louvamos pela vossa manifestação de poder. Envia teu Espírito sobre nós. És digno de honra, glória e louvor, Senhor.
Your watch missing?
I just have a middle name.
No.
That's all. And this one is a middle name.
Well, if you want to change it, I'll let you change it after we're finished.
After, okay.
So if you don't teach him and understand this with the church and all the teachings of Christ, when he comes to that age, he won't understand what he's doing. So you're promising today to make sure when it comes to that stage, he will grow in the faith and understand it. Okay? That's all the preaching of winner. So. The Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit, amen. Nathan has been chosen by his parents for a Christian way of life. It is a way of love and kindness. I now invite you to accept this responsibility. So what name have you chosen for?
Nathan.
Nathan Justin. And what do you ask of God's church for your child? You've asked to have Nathan baptized. In doing so, you accept the responsibility of training him in the practice of his faith. It will be your duty to bring him up to keep God's commandments as Christ taught us by loving God and our neighbour. Do you clearly understand what you're undertaking?
We do.
And to the godparents, are you ready to help the parents of this child and their duty as Christian parents? The Christian community welcomes you with great joy in his name. I claim you for Christ our Saviour. I now make the sign of the cross on Nathan's forehead and I invite the parents and godparents to do the same. So what I'm actually doing is I'm claiming Nathan for Christ, his church for life, and you're doing the same. You're putting the sign of the cross on and you're also agreeing. The four of you agree that's what you want. And Nathan, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Today, so the readings they have, they're not on your wee booklets because they vary depending on who's doing the baptism. The first one I've chosen here is from St. Paul to the Galatians. It's the qualities and the gifts of the Holy Spirit. These are the gifts that you hope Nathan will grow up with in the home. The Psalms are from "The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want." You normally hear these at a funeral rather than a baptism, but fullness of baptisms not fulfilled until we meet Christ at the end of our day. So that links the two together. The Paschal candle, if you see, it's lit for this. It'll be lit also at the end of days forever. And the gospel is where Christ has given us commandment. It's not in your booklet. Given us a commandment to go and baptize in his name, the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. So we're just doing what he has commanded us to do today as well. So the first reading is from St. Paul to the Galatians. The Spirit produces love, joy, peace, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, humility, and self-control. Those who belong to Jesus Christ fight their selfish desires. The Spirit has given us life. We must control our lives. We must not be proud or irritate one another or be jealous of one another. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. And the response to the psalm is, "The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want."
The Lord is my shepherd,
there is nothing I shall want. Fresh and green are the pastures, where he gives me repose. Near restful waters he leads me to revive my drooping spirit. Response.
The Lord is my shepherd,
he guides me along the right path, he is true to his name. If I should walk in the valley of darkness, no evil would I fear. You are there with your crook and your staff, with these you give me comfort. Response. Surely goodness and kindness shall follow me all the days of my life, and the Lord's own house shall I dwell for ever and ever. Response.
The Lord is my shepherd, there's nothing I shall want.
So, the Lord be with you. I'll read the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. Glory to you, O Lord. Meanwhile, the 11 disciples set out for Galilee to the mountain where Jesus had arranged to meet them. When they saw him, they fell down before him, though some hesitated. Jesus came up and spoke to them. He said, "All authority in heaven and on earth has been given to me. Go therefore and make disciples of all the nations, baptize them in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, and teach them to observe all the commandments I give you, and know that I am with you always, yes, to the end of time." The Gospel of the Lord. You see it again? So today we're fulfilling for Nathan what Christ has commanded us to do. So just move on into the prayers of the faithful, and which the Lord graciously hears as a response. They are in your rebook, aren't they? Yeah.
By the mystery of your death and resurrection, we have made him in life, given new life, and baptized him and welcomed him into your holy church. Lord, we baptize him in confirmation, make him your faithful follower and a witness to your gospel. Lord, hear us. Lead Nathan by a holy life to the joys of God's kingdom. Lord, hear us. And make the lives of Nathan's mother and father and godparents examples of faith to inspire him as he goes through life. Renew the grace of baptism in each one of us present here today. Lord, hear us. So, the next part of the ceremony is called the exorcism, which is where we're born in the stain of original sin. And this prayer removes that from Nathan. And then I'm going to anoint him on the top of the chest with the oil of catechumens. And it meant to give us strength to overcome the temptations of the world by through our own. Just a, maybe a tap two buttons. Almighty and ever-living God, you sent your only Son into the world to cast out the power of Satan's spirit of evil, to rescue us from the kingdom of darkness and bring us into the splendor of your kingdom of light. Pray for Nathan, set him free from original sin, make him a temple of your glory, and send your Holy Spirit to dwell in him. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. We anoint you with the oil of salvation in the name of Christ your Savior. Be strengthened with his power, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen.
Point that out to you. I need the four of you to respond to all these because Nathan will be doing it for himself, confirmation, but today you're professing for him. So, my dear brothers and sisters, we now ask God to give Nathan new life in abundance through water and the Holy Spirit. So, I'm going to bless the water in which Nathan was baptized. Praise to you, God, Almighty Father, for you have created water to cleanse and to give life. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ, the Father's only Son, who offered yourself on the cross, that in blood and water flowed from your side, and through your death and resurrection, the church might be born. Praise to you, God, the Holy Spirit, who anointed Christ at his baptism and the waters of the Jordan, so that we might all be baptized into you. Come to us, Lord, Father of all, and make holy this water which you have created, so that all who are baptized in it may be washed clean of sin and be born again to live as your children. Make this water holy, Lord, so all who are baptized into Christ's death and resurrection may by this water become more perfectly like your Son.
Amen.
We'll bless the water now, which Nathan's going to be baptized. So, Lord, make holy this water which you have created, so that all those whom you have chosen may be born again by the power of the Holy Spirit and take their place among your holy people. Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. Dear parents and godparents, we come here to present Nathan for baptism. By water and the Holy Spirit, he has received the gift of new life from God, who is love. On your part, you must make it your constant care to bring him up in the practice of the faith. See that that divine life which God has given to him is kept safe from the poison of sin, to grow always stronger in his heart. If your faith makes you ready to accept this responsibility, renew now the vows of your own baptism, reject sin, profess your faith in Christ Jesus. This is the faith of the church. This is the faith in which Nathan is about to be baptized. Do you reject Satan?
I do.
and all his works?
I do.
And all his empty promises?
I do.
Do you believe in God the Father, Almighty Creator of heaven and earth?
I do.
Do you believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was born of the Virgin Mary, was crucified, died and was buried, and rose from the dead, and is now seated at the right hand of the Father?
I do.
Do you believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of sins, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting?
I do.
This is our faith. This is the faith of the Church. We're proud to profess it in Christ Jesus, our Lord. Amen.
Amen.
So I'm going to invite the five of you to come down to the baptismal font. So is it your wish to have Nathan baptised in the faith we just professed?
Yes.
And it's Nathan, Justin.
Justin.
Do you want to put your head down nearly into my hand, Nathan? Put your head on down. No, your head. That's it. And just hold it together. Nathan, I baptise you in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. There you go, Mum. You dry that for him? Or do you have a towel of your own? Good.
Yes.
Yeah, good stuff. Yeah, it'll be right. You're not doing a great show, you're not doing. Good morning. So, do you want to just take a photograph whenever? So, if you want it, more around me, but not.
Yeah.
Not really there. Yeah. Nathan has become a new creation and clothed himself in Christ. Seeing this white garment, the outward sign of his Christian dignity, with his family and friends to help him by word and example, bring that dignity unstained with an everlasting life in heaven. Amen. So, could I invite the godparents to put beside me with a candle? Nathan has been christened and is now called a child of God. Please God, you have the joy of being with him on First Communion Day and see him to go on mature Christian living on Confirmation Day when the fullness of God's Spirit will be given to him. So together we just all like to stand for our Father. Do you want to say it in your own language? As she thanks God for their safe delivery, may she find joy in the love, growth, and holiness of Nathan. And for the Father, God is the giver of life, human and divine. May he bless the Father of this child. With his wife, he will be the first of teachers in the ways of faith. May they be the best of teachers, bearing witness to the faith by what they say and what they do. And finally, just for the godparents. By God's gift through water and the Holy Spirit, we are reborn to everlasting life. In his goodness, may he continue to pour out his blessings upon these sons and daughters of his. May he make them always, wherever they may be, faithful members of his holy people. And may he send his peace upon all who are gathered here in Christ Jesus our Lord. Amen. And may God bless you all, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Well done, Nathan. So, feel free to take one look there. I'll back out in a minute again. If you want to change the form, you can put it in.
Yes.
You want to come to start? Yes. Yeah.
Thank you.
Jesus, nós te louvamos pela vossa manifestação de poder. Envia teu Espírito sobre nós. És digno de honra, glória e louvor, Senhor.
Espírito, enche o meu ser.
speak.